early 1920s, while Sir Robert Croydon was governor in Uganda, the British colonialists were committed to end the extreme human behavior of cannibalism. Reports show they were not successful. Cannibalism continued in many parts of Uganda. Around 1922 or 1923, in Buikwe, three men, Kawulu, Luvaluka and Leo Zabazungu, were arrested and charged with murder and cannibalism. The three were convicted on a charge of killing and eating a young girl called Dahlia, who was returning from school. They were sentenced to hanging in public. Kawulu's village Chigenda in Buikwe was named after him following that incident, and since then, Buikwe and Bukunja County in Jeno has been unpopular for cannibalism, although it is not true that everyone who lives there is a cannibal. Humans have been mysterious in many ways, but understanding why a human would prey on something prone, something even more defenseless like a fellow human, is more mysterious.
It is a dissociation between thinking and cognition resulting from loss of reality. It begins in the mind, and that fantasy part of the mind, or pleasure part of the mind, that somebody begins to think about it, and then due to the pattern, the growing consecutive traits, you'll find that somebody has embarked on that kind of thinking.
The Chachirugo incident in Rakai, where Pischo Mukam and her one-year-old son were butchered and eaten, could prove as true some legends in our modern history. Most legends have it that eating a corpse of a dead person was common practice in many parts of Uganda. Scientists call this necrocannibalism, as opposed to homicidal cannibalism, where a human is killed for food. If court proves that Chomukam and her son were butchered and eaten, it will be the second homicidal cannibalism case on record since 1922. In some African societies, cannibalism was a cultural norm. Some people have done it as a ritual practice with the belief that it can send away spirits of the dead.
So when somebody's mind starts to think about it, probably due to the result of exposure to the kind of behavior, the cannibalism behavior from the parents or from other family generations, it is easy for such a person to start feeling it.
The Fodes Sanko Revolutionary United Front, a rebel army that fought a failed war in Sierra Leone for 11 years from 1991, was accused of cannibalism, amongst other atrocities. Some rebels claimed that eating parts of their victims, like a heart, would keep away the victim's spirit, which would otherwise torment his or her killers. In some instances, cannibalism has been used as a last resort by people in famine conditions. In the Bible, for example, the book of 2 Kings chapter 6 talks of a great famine that struck the city of Samaria, so great that accounts of people killing and boiling their own children for food emerged. The recent example of cannibalism for survival is the 1972 crash of Uruguayan Air Force Flight 571 in Andes, South America. Faced with starvation, survivors resorted to eating corpses of dead passengers and were able to survive for 72 days. In some societies, human flesh was thought to have medicinal components in it. This 73-year-old man of Bokibeti, Magale sub-county in Manafa district, tells me how he ate human flesh so he could get children of his own. He says he had lost 4 children in their infancy, and he needed a solution. Eating human flesh to get children is not a practice of Bagesu, according to Augustine Wandida, a cultural leader in Imbale. However, this man insists that human flesh, until today, is the only known solution in case a man or woman fails to bear children.
It could be, if it is used as a medicine, and you know some people who have got their medicine, that is a secret to them. They may not reveal it if it is their income generating.
Axoferi's wives bore him 11 children. But it is difficult to know whether human flesh was the decisive factor in this.
So,
The wide belief in most Ugandan societies is that there is a bad spirit that manifests itself through cannibalism. Some traditional spiritualists claim they can exorcise it.
Tuino chini cha wanga afurumia nota niko kolachi okusitula enyama abafu ngamuga nyogutereza ngosera nulia nukulia. Netubayo nechini batenda walumbe tanda na ya asezesa. Abandi bagende tanda. Walumbe nga abanjo ya atuta. Asezesa danuri ya lechovula antinga. Bwaba arosa. Arosa nyabafu.
Spiritualists also differ when it comes to this evil spirit. Some saying it cannot leave its host completely.
Echo kuli echo. Gwo mchala agenzo kufumba. Bwo manyangati ufumbidua mfamili area. Gwo jangu weganga. Banda bachile meba kuata. Nenga tuja kuchija wachokulia techivao.
Techivao.
Echisindi kechajo kufumba no mchala techivao.
There is no outright deterrent law on cannibalism, except a person who exhumes a corpse can be charged with trespassing on a burial ground and could serve a custodial sentence of not more than 3 years. In case one kills and eats a human, they can be charged with murder and disappearance of a person. The 13 Rakai cannibalism suspects will soon be put on trial in Masaka High Court on charges of murder and disappearance of Pischo Mukama and her one-year-old son Kamunini, but not eating human flesh. Frank Walusimbi, NTV.